John de Vries joins us from Black Rock Mining on quite an exciting day for the company. John, your DFS is out on the Mahenge project in Tanzania. Graphite, very exciting milestone to have reached. Please tell us about the highlights in this DFS, about this operating model that you're shaping up.
Well, Daniel, thank you for talking today. We're very, very excited. I mean, we've put 9 months of hard work into the DFS, and we've produced what I think is simply the best piece of work I've done in the last 35 years. We've got an NPV of $895 million after tax, after free carried interest. And put that into perspective, that's 1.2 billion Australian dollars on a project. We've had the capital is come up a little bit. It's 115 million, but we're still talking about nine times your return on capital. We have an IRR of 42.8%, and all in operating cost, our C1 operating cost at the moment is $400 a tonne. So it's $400 a tonne for a product that sells around about $1,300 a tonne. So for every dollar of cost we get in, we pull in about $3 of revenue, and that's just an absolutely stunning business. For people who don't understand graphite, I'll put that into a gold analogy. That's like a gold mine producing gold for $400 an ounce, selling it for $1,200 an ounce, and a pathway to build a 250,000 ounce a year gold mine. It's a stunning business.
Tell me more about what you've learned in the past month, in the past 9 months rather, between your PFS and DFS. I understand you were mentioning to me earlier about the logistics being a really key part of the attractiveness of this project.
We started off the DFS along the lines of saying, look, we need to prove the geology, we need to prove the metallurgy, so we have a very high level of confidence about engineering. And we've done that. We've demonstrated that we can get to better than 99% concentrate. We've demonstrated very good recovery, and we've demonstrated a flow sheet that is simple and easy to operate. But what's come along is we've put the study together, we've really began to understand that not only do we have a geological advantage, but we have a very significant geographic advantage. And that comes in two forms. Firstly, it's grid power, and that is we can bring power to site. It's going to cost us about 8.5 cents a unit off the grid versus about 32 cents a unit if I was to rent a diesel power station and run that on diesel. The other one that's really starting to come up now and we're getting our minds around is just understanding the sheer leverage available through having rail access 60 kilometres from site and having that rail go straight into the biggest port in our region in Dar es Salaam. So that gives us access to low-cost, high-frequency shipping to Asia and gives us access to empty containers available at the port. Both of which are strategic advantages. And then the way to think about that is, you know, if you were to fly to London, you would it's much cheaper to fly from Sydney Airport to London than it is from Dubbo Airport to London. And graphite shipping is no different. It's very expensive to ship from a regional port to a major international port and then on to your final destination. We're lucky we have got rails straight into the international port, and that's a massive advantage that we're really starting to come across now.
So turning now, John, to the pilot plant, can you tell me about the role that this plays?
Look, the pilot plant's actually defined our entire definitive feasibility study strategy. At 90 tonnes, the pilot plant is 10 times larger than anybody else in the sector at the study stage. What that means is that we have 90 tonnes through the pilot plant, we have 8 tonnes of concentrate, and we've got 24 customers with this concentrate in their hands. And how that comes together is we suddenly have customers who can work with our concentrate and realise, hey, it is really, really good. That feeds back into our financiers who turn around and go, well, not only have you done the engineering right because you've got the enormous volume through the concentrate, but you've got customers who are now happy. Therefore, we're going to start talking to you. And our customers go, oh, because the banks are now talking to you, you'll probably get financed. And it begins to come together very quickly. So we're very happy that on the back of that pilot plant, it's been a strategic pathway to securing customers, and it's a strategic pathway to securing finance because we've secured the customers.
And a major agreement that you put out recently was with the Yantai Group to provide process plant machinery and access to project finance. What can you tell me about this deal and other deals you're working on?
Well, Yantai are fundamental to the overall project delivery. And I'll put it into perspective. We've only had three graphite projects delivered in the Western world in the last 10 years, and that's the Akum project for Imris in Namibia. We've had Valence in South Australia and Sierra, obviously, in Mozambique. So there isn't a vast inventory of experience sitting out there of graphite projects. Yantai have participated in four projects in China in the last 10 years. So between Yantai and CPC here in Australia, I've got an engineering panel that's built five projects in the last 10 years, and that's five projects more than anybody else. So Yantai's contribution is twofold. Not only is it as a single source supplier to deliver us a cost advantage, but importantly, it's the capacity to bring that IP in to understand what works and what doesn't work when we really don't have a big inventory of experience in the industry. So it's a twofold contribution. Where we are at the moment, we're just shipping a bulk sample of ore to Yantai. They're going to run their own independent pilot plant to do two things. They're going to validate our work. So again, that just to me improves the overall bankability. But once they've validated the work, they'll start stepping up to the commitments they've made around funding the capital, or a good portion of the capital for the project. So it's something we're looking forward to. And it's certainly going to be important to us over the next couple of months, and we hope to get this done before the Chinese New Year in early February.
So you did give me a bit of a teaser there, but can you remind us, please, what are those big milestones moving forwards? I know it's a huge one we've hit today with the DFS, but of course, we're always looking for more good news. When's it coming? What is it?
This thing really begins to move. What we're moving now as we exit the DFS, obviously we want to tell a lot of people about how good the DFS is. But the people we really want to work with on the DFS is going to be our customers. Our customers will look at, and we've got cornerstone customers now, will look at the study and go, okay, we understand what you're going to do, and we now have a high level of confidence that you're going to be able to deliver. Therefore, the customers start to come on board, and obviously that feeds into the finance. So I think, you know, there should be a good news flow around customers and finance, and obviously the third component on that is going to be Yantai and the output from Yantai and how we're working with Yantai to advance the physical construction of the project. I think the final part coming out of it is Tanzania. We've seen Tanzania issue a lot of mining licenses in the short in recent history, and certainly that we have now our environmental permit. So we're confident that the permitting is now really beginning to work, and we're confident that we'll be able to secure a mining license reasonably quickly, and it should be easy to do given the quality of the work that we've put into front-end loading that process.
Well, John, it's a very exciting time. Thank you very much for taking the time out to talk to us today. We'll be following the journey.
Thank you. Cheerio.